Hey, thanks very much. Thanks for coming out. Much appreciated. The name of this band is Shorter Stories. We're going to be playing the music of Wayne Shorter tonight. The name of the band kind of comes from the fact that one time in an interview, Wayne was asked, so after he had moved on to play with Weather Report, you know, why aren't you writing more for Weather Report? You're such a great composer. And his response was, well, Weather Report plays novels, but I write short stories. So that first tune was Children of the Night, and it was originally composed for an album by Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers called Mosaic that came out in 1961. Most of the music that we're going to be playing tonight kind of comes from that sort of 1960 to 1966 period, so it kind of focuses on that early part of Wayne's career. And that tune was a straight transcription off the record, but most of the stuff we're going to do tonight is actually original arrangements. We're going to follow that with one of the newer tunes. This is a tune called Adam's Apple, which comes from Wayne's solo record by the same name, which was released in 1966. And this one is in 7/4. Thank you. Thank you. So while I was doing some research for this project, I discovered that bands used to make records at much faster pace than they do now. In the 5 years that that Wayne was with Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, from 1959 to 1964, the band recorded 22 albums, many of which were live, but still, that's an incredible pace. And kind of talking about that same subject, the year 1964 produced three of Wayne's most beloved solo records. In that year, he recorded Night Dreamer, Speak No Evil, and Juju, all three. And we're going to be doing a bunch of tunes from those three records. We're going to start that off with an arrangement of Juju. Thank you. For those of you keeping score at home, that was 11. Okay, we're going to do something really boring in four now that also happens to be very, very pretty. This is a tune called Infant Eyes, and you're finally going to get to hear from Bob Dunn on the guitar on this one. So this is Infant Eyes.
Thank you. Thank you. So Wayne was on, as I mentioned, Wayne was on the Jazz Messengers for 5 years. Toward the end, I'm not sure when exactly this happened, he eventually became the musical director of the group and called all the shots. At that time, Miles Davis called him up and tried to entice him off the Blakey band. And his response was, well, I still have some work to do here. You know, I feel like I still have some things I can accomplish. So he stayed on that band till 64 when Miles called again. And when Miles calls twice, you really probably ought to take it. And so he did, and joined Miles, and they played their first show, I think, at the Hollywood Bowl. And no rehearsal, right? So they show up on the bandstand, play the show. This is the first time Miles has heard the band with Wayne, because prior to that, he'd been through a number of tenor players. George Coleman for quite a while, Sam Rivers at one point, I don't know who all else. Joe Henderson, I think, played with him for a while. So Wayne, after the show, he got back to his hotel, and the phone rings, and it's Miles, and I'm not going to try to do the Miles voice because I'll embarrass myself, but he says, we're going into the studio on Monday to record. He's heard the band one time, and he's ready to record. So Wayne says, okay, so he shows up at the studio, and he brought along with him this book of tunes that he had written. He was in the Army, and while he was in the Army, he'd sort of jot stuff down, write some tunes, and so he brings the book out, and Miles said, you got something? Wayne says, yeah, you know. They look through the book, and Miles points and says, that one. And it ended up being ESP. And so ESP was the first tune of Wayne's that that Miles recorded on the album of the same name. And Wayne only found out when the album came out that he had chosen that tune as the title track. And so thereafter, every time the band was going to go into the studio, Miles would call him up and say, hey, Wayne, going into the studio, bring the book.
Thank you.
Thanks very much, ESP. Would you like to meet the fellas? All right. On drum set, he brought an extra floor tom tonight just so he could play that kicking the drums down the staircase fill in that last tune. Josh Hackinson. This fella is no stranger to the Noche stage. I'm sure you've seen him a lot with the Mike Conrad Trio and other groups. On bass, Dr. Alexander Pashonin. On the guitar, Mr. Bob Guitar Dunn. Cedar Falls legend. This guy, I understand, has a room downstairs that he stays in because he's here all the time. On piano, my dear friend, Dr. Michael Conrad. On trombone, he was just here the last two nights along with Mike, right? You're here with... just last night. Okay, well, okay, with Max's group. On trombone, the great Anthony Williams. And so we are all UNI people, but this guy is an invited guest. And man, when you play like that, you get invited to a lot of places. From the University of Wisconsin La Crosse, right? John Alabuni. All right, my name is Christopher Merz, and thank you. Thanks very much. We're going to close this set with an arrangement that John made of the tune Mahjong, which I believe is that also from Night Dreamer? Or Juju, yeah, from Juju, also from 1964. So this is John's arrangement of Mahjong, a la Latin. They're getting rowdy back there. Thanks very much. We're going to take a little intermission and come back with a few more tunes for you. Thanks for sticking around. Call your friends.
'Cause another
Thank you. Just a little palate cleanser before we bring the full band back on. So that was a tune called Fee-Fi-Fo-Fum. I don't know if you had in your mind an image of a giant crashing through a castle. I try to keep that in my mind every time I play that tune. There are a few crashing moments in there, even with just the two of us. Okay, so like I said at the top of the show, most of this stuff has been fairly significantly messed with, which is what arrangers do. But some of Wayne's tunes are so perfect that you can't mess with them, right? And this would be in that category. This is a tune, again, that he wrote for Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers. Not sure when this record came out, 61 maybe, I'm not sure. It's from the record Caravan. This is a tune called This Is for Albert that was written for Bud Powell. It's in honor of Bud Powell. This is for Albert. Thank you. Okay, so that one was just a straight transcription, not messed with at all. This next one is extremely messed with. This is a tune from, I think this is from Speak No Evil, I'm not sure. It's called Deluge. And, well, there's a transition in the middle, you'll hear it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. This one is a little bit truer to the original, although I had a little fun with this one. This is the title track from the album Night Dreamer, which is one of that pod of records that Wayne made in 1964. Got to get the starter horn for this one. Thank you. Josh Hackinson on the drums. Okay, on the further adventures of Messed With, this is a tune called Speak No Evil from the album of the same name. And it's significantly altered, so enjoy yourselves.
Thank you.
Thanks very much. We would like to thank you all for being here for our coming out party. This is our very first show, and we're really excited. Well, anyway, I'm excited. I can't speak for these guys, and I'm thrilled. I spent most of my summer making these charts, so it's nice to finally actually get them in front of people. Thank you. Thanks very much. So the band is called Shorter Stories, so hopefully we'll be playing some other venues soon. I'll tell you again who the fellas are on drum set, Mr. Josh Hackinson. On the bass, Mr. Alexander Fershunen. On guitar, my bestie, Mr. Bob Dunn. On piano, you know him, you love him, you can't live without him, Dr. Michael Conrad. On trombone, Dr. Anthony Williams. On trumpet, all the way from Wisconsin, Mr. John Alabuni. The Eagles up there in Oakland, lacrosse, yeah. All right, my name is Christopher Merz, and thank you. We have one more tune for you, and this is it's hard to know when these things were written, right, because Wayne had this book that he was putting together in the Army, but I think this is one of the earliest ones that was ever recorded. I think he recorded it, like, really, really early, and then also on an album with Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers called The Big Beat, which came out in 1960. This is called Lester Left Town. Thank you. Thank you very much. Shorter stories.